Well, we are gathered here today to witness the coming together of two people. And I believe it is two people whose hearts and spirits and minds really are already as one. Those of you who know them best, you can already attest to the love that they have for one another and to the blended hopes and dreams and goals that they share together. And when such a bond exists like that, it becomes only natural and appropriate that we have a public demonstration of that love, such as this wedding ceremony. So it is now today that Mike and Mathilda are going to profess before God, before you as family members, and the remainder of you as friends, their desire to walk the road of life together from here on out. Do you take Mathilda to be your wedded wife, to live together in the holy estate of matrimony? And will you love her, comfort her, honor her, and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep yourself only for her as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Mathilda, do you today take Mike to be your wedded husband, to live together in the holy estate of matrimony? And will you love him, comfort him, honor him, and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep yourself only for him as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Mathilda, my love, you look so incredibly beautiful today. It reminds me of when we met in Clarkson Library, and then at a packed night at Maxfield's, when we sat in the middle of a bar, and we just talked for hours and hours, like we were the only people there. I vow to be better about telling you how beautiful your smile is, and how it always brightens my day. I will always cherish your give me a kiss look in the morning when one of us leaves for work, as it is the absolute cutest, and it keeps me from staying away for too long. I love that you got me our very own adventure book for my birthday, and I love that we always find a way to get away. But our shared passions go much deeper than that. We share similar visions and goals for the future, and I vow to always be there to love, comfort, and cherish you as our adventures continue. I smile, and I can't wait to spend the rest of my life enjoying it that much more, being able to share it with you.
Mike, I remember the first time we met in that tiny library back at Clarkson University. I knew there was something special about you. I could tell you were kind, loving, smart, and plus you were very good looking, which was a bonus. I was mesmerized. I'm standing here today in front of family and friends because I choose you. I choose you to be my husband, the father of our children, to be my partner and my best friend. Marriage isn't always easy. It's a journey, and I can't imagine anyone else that I'd rather take this epic adventure with. I vow that no matter what peaks and valleys we go through as a couple, I'll be there for you. I'll be there for our family through the sunshine and through the rain. The Bible says two hands are better than one. Mike, you're my gift from God, and I'm eternally grateful for the love that we share. You encourage me, support me. You challenge me to be better and to do better, to find joy and gratitude in the simple things, and to be generous. I love that on this journey we're about to begin, we will have shared goals, visions, and dreams that we will achieve together. I can't wait to travel the world with you, to Netflix and chill, and to create a family of our own. I vow to love and honor you all the days of my life.
Well, for as much as Mike and Mathilda have consented together in holy wedlock today, and they have witnessed that before God and before you as family and friends, they have declared all that by joining hands and giving and receiving rings, I hereby pronounce you are indeed husband and wife together, and what God has joined together, let no man ever put asunder. We've done all the legal things we need to do to make sure the two of you are married. Let's have some fun. You can kiss your bride, Mike. And now face your family and friends. Folks, I'm going to ask you to get on your feet now. You can get really loud as I welcome for the first time Mr. and Mrs. Michael and Mathilda Traylor.
I'll go into a little spiel. I'm the quote-unquote mutual friend, so everyone's gathered here today for a reason. You're welcome. Okay. Okay, so Mathilda and I first met back in 2015 because we were in the same occupational therapy program, and as time went on, we developed a close friendship and shared numerous memories, such as going to church, praying together, and having movie night at our apartments. And the start of Mathilda and Mike. So in our first semester, we had anatomy class, and we would always go to the library, and Mathilda would always mention, oh, the guy at the next table, he's so cute. She raved about him being a ginger and his and his blue eyes. And the more she mentioned his cuteness, I started initiating conversations with Mike, asking him about anatomy, school stuff, interests, and we both grew up in Florida, so we talked about that. And I would drag Mathilda along with me each time I went to talk to him. And then as time went on, there was this one fateful night at Maxfield's where Mags and I were able to get them alone at a table together, and they talked for hours. And the next day, Mathilda said she had so much in common with him, and the rest is history. Prior to meeting Mike, Mathilda has always been kind and generous, but being with you, Mike, she glows differently. I see it in the way she smiles, the way she talks about you, and within her actions. So thank you, Mike, for being patient, kind, caring, and loving my friend. Your love for one another is truly inspiring. So may everyone please raise their glasses. To Mr. and Mrs. Michael and Mathilda Trailer, may this in journey that you've gone be loving and adventurous. Cheers.
I'd like to take this opportunity to tell you a little bit about my brother, Mike. He's an incredibly kind and thoughtful individual who is constantly going above and beyond for his friends and loved ones. He's always there to lend a hand or a calm, thoughtful, and understanding ear. And he's a great cook, too. And he's just the best, and I feel so fortunate to have him as my brother. And it just fills me with joy to know that he's got this wonderful wife, and to see the way he and Mathilda love and support each other. So thank you, Mathilda, for making him so happy. And so here's to the happy couple. I love you guys.
Each and every night, I look up at the stars, and even though you don't see them sometimes, they are there. And I wish upon the stars that all my friends and family, which will now include all of you, are safe and healthy and happy and will feel my love. So next time you look up, know that I'm thinking of you and wishing you well with love. So remember, mama is only a phone call or a text away, no matter what time it is. And everyone else, remember to look up and always feel my love.
Good evening, everyone. Many of you have come a long distance, and we're so happy that you're here to celebrate this special occasion with Mike and Mathilda. From the first time I saw them together, it was clear that they share a tremendous love and respect for one another. It is obvious that Mike and Mathilda truly thrive in each other's company and will do what it takes to create a future of love, laughter, and happiness.
My sister is the kindest person you'll ever meet. She made this Thanksgiving feel like every other Thanksgiving. It was just the three of us, and it felt like family was there. Like, it truly did feel like family was there. And Mike is the most kind-hearted and most good-natured guy. And the second I met him, I was like, I really like this guy. And he just made me feel like I was talking to a brother. And he got my jokes, which meant a lot to me. And like, I don't know, just talking to him and seeing how like my sister and Mathilda and Mike interacted, it made them feel like everything just felt right. And I was with family. And for me, that ended up being one of the most memorable Thanksgivings. And to this day, I always feel like I'm around family when I'm with you, Mike. And I'm so glad that you get to be a part of our family and I get to be a part of your family.
I just want to give a blessing to the beautiful bride and groom. And it's coming from me and Tete Teo, who's sorry she couldn't be here. But we are very proud of you, and we welcome you, Mike, to our family, and we wish you the best. So may the future hold your every happiness. May the future hold your vibrant health. May the future hold for you prosperity. and may the future hold all the love you share today in your hearts, between you and from your friends and family, and may that love multiply with each passing year. Cheers to Mathilda and Mike.
I commend you today for taking this step in your lives, and now that you have entrusted your love to this institution of marriage, I trust and believe in faith that your love is going to shine and even brighter from this day forth. Character and integrity, the pastor said today. I say to you, 1 Corinthians chapter 13, love is patient, love is kind, love is Mike and Mathilda. God bless you.
Mike and Mathilda, today we celebrate you, and we celebrate also with you in absentia. You have both done a beautiful and honorable thing, which we are so proud of. Congratulations on this, your wedding day. Love and greetings from Zimbabwe. Now this certificate, she has not worked it for it yet. But you just got it. How amazing. This is the only certificate you get without working for it. You get it, then you work for it. Love you, your mother. Welcome, my son.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. And you know, they save the best for last. All right, Mike and Mathilda, congratulations. Makorokoto, tinotenda. And for respecting our culture and our way of life, we'll forever cherish that. And we'll do everything to support you and your life as you go on from now onwards. And one more time with the water glass, whatever you have here, let's raise our glasses and say congratulations to Mike and Mathilda. Makorokoto. Congratulations.